Hi everyone, Victor is here. Today I'm going to sketch my guitar, model Hohner HW350.
Materials used for this painting are the paper SMLT, watercolor paper 100% cotton, 300 GSM cold press. Cold press means it has a more rough texture. The colors I'll be using is sepia. Yellow ochre. And ultramarine blue. Water spray bottle, masking tape for gluing the paper on the board, the brushes I'll be using are Tintoretto. And a pencil. To make a more precise drawing, I'll be using a ruler to divide the paper in thirds, in nine rectangles. So I'll divide in three parts the length and I'll make nine rectangles. Now I'll be using these guidelines to roughly sketch the main lines of the body part of the guitar. Today I'd like to practice graduation value. So I'll draw only the body part of the guitar where there is a shape that can be studied. This is the whole of the guitar, seen from perspective, it's not a circle, it's a elliptical shape. Here is the neck of the guitar. Now I'll erase the guidelines. Thank you. I'll start with a flat wash of yellow ochre. The body of guitar. This is wet on dry technique, meaning the paper is dry and I am applying the color quickly. Using water to spread it more easily. Now I'll wait until the paper completely dries. The paper completely dried. Now the second step is to paint the rest part of the body of the guitar. Now I'll be using burnt sienna, very diluted. Also, it is wet on dry technique. With wet on dry technique, we can control better the watercolor. So in whatever the direction we give to the color, it will go in that direction. With the wet on wet technique, the watercolor is unpredictable. We cannot control in which direction it will go. So for a more successful painting, a combination of wet technique and wet on dry technique is advisable. So this burnt sienna has a reddish hue. It's a natural hue. Resembles the color of bricks. For the neck of guitar, we'll start with wet on dry technique and farther away of the neck we'll be using the wet on wet technique to give a less defined shape as it moves farther away from the main part of the interest. So for this we'll wet before the paper, before applying the color, we'll wet it. And after we wet it, we wait a bit for the water to soak into the paper. So at the end of the neck, as can be seen, the color flows by itself. We gave it some direction between the lines of the drawing, and now it flows freely in all directions. Only in that part where the paper is wet. For the whole of the guitar, we'll be using a much darker hue. I'll mix some sepia. With ultramarine blue, more sepia, I'll add also burnt sienna. Now for the hole, also we are using wet on dry technique. until the body of the guitar dries, we can work on the right side of the background. It will be wet on wet technique. So we'll wet the paper. We will be using a mixture of sienna and ultramarine blue for the background. Wet on wet technique. The result is unpredictable. It can be surprising to see so organic shapes. So we can control the color where the brush touches the dry part of the paper. Where it's wet, it flows freely in any direction. So one still wet part of the painting, we can add more color. It is called charging, and the colors mix on the paper. Now we can move to the left part of the background. There the color will be more diluted with water, so we can use the same mixture. And here also we'll be using wet on wet technique. So let the paper to soak into the paper. here carefully not to touch the already wet color, because they will run together. So this is close, almost close to the already painted area. So here we'll be using very diluted color with a lot of water. So to dilute it more, we spread this color on the paper. Now we can continue to the dried part of the guitar. We'll add more details. Mixing sepia with ultramarine it gives us a dark, very dark color. Here is a mixture of burnt sienna and sepia. To have a more precise drawing, I hold the brush more close to the tip of the brush. To indicate the frets of the neck, I'll be using a flat brush. For the side part of the body, we'll be using graduated wash. So to make the color more less saturated, and to make gradation, we rinse the brush and dry it on the paper towel, and we mix the color on the paper. Until we have a gradation with more water. Now again rinse, dry, so the brush needs to be damp, not very wet. Again, rinse, dry, and then mix on the paper. So we get a gradation in this way. It is useful to create this technique to create three-dimensional shapes. The watercolors, after they dry, they get lighter. So we can reinstate summer years.
Here is a simple watercolor sketch where I used wet on wet, dry on wet, and graduated value range techniques. I hope you enjoyed this video and you'll find it useful. Thanks for watching. Bye!